So now you have all that good real estate content and you're ready to go. But now you're wondering, how do I edit it? Watch this video and I will show you how easy it is to edit your real estate videos using just iMovie. Thank you so much for being here. For more tips on how to use technology in real estate to gain more customers and sell more homes, please subscribe to my channel and click on the bell so that you're notified when I post a new video every Wednesday. Have you ever watched other people's videos and wonder how they look so good? Have you thought this must be out of my reach because that person must be spending thousands of dollars to have their video edited for them? You may be surprised to hear that most of the videos out there could be edited using just iMovie. By the end of this video, I will show you some tips on how easy it is to edit your videos using iMovie where you can spend $0. Ever since starting content marketing years ago, I have relied on iMovie so much and has saved me so much money. So here we go. When you first open iMovie, you will see an option there to either create a movie or a trailer. I always select movie as the best option for editing. A trailer is a good way to have iMovie make your movie look like it's a trailer for a movie. So if you're ever wanting to do a parody or something like that, this may be a good option. But for the case of what we're doing here today, you'll want to select movie. Start by taking all the video you have taken and upload it into iMovie. This may be just one very long clip or a series of clips. For the purpose of this demonstration, I'm going to pull all my videos that I took on my Instagram stories for a festival that we recently hosted downtown in our city. All I do is upload all the videos I took into the downloads folder of my computer and then pull them and put them on the bottom portion of iMovie. Most of these times you'll have them in order already, but since I pulled these from Instagram stories, they did not go in order and therefore I have to reorder them. All you have to do is select a clip and then drag it where you want it to go. Now that all my clips are in order, I can start editing them. First thing I want to do is add a title or an opening to let my people know what my video is about. For this, I am going to use Canva. I use Canva all the time. If you ever need to create a logo, you need to put text overlay, or you need to create some sort of graphic. Canva is amazing and can do so much, has so much potential. So I'm quickly going to go in there and make a banner title for my video. As you can see, Canva gives you a bunch of predetermined templates that you can choose from. Since I'm going to export this video as a 1080p resolution, I want to select custom dimensions. If you Google the dimensions of a 1080p video, you will see that they are 1920 by 1080. Therefore, this is what I will put in the dimensions for Canva, as I know it'll fit my video perfectly. First thing I will do is change the background. If you click in there, you are given the option to use custom colors. I am going to use the hex codes for my company's colors, which you can find yours online to make it simple. This way I can brand it towards myself and my company. Then I add a title, and again I can change it to the company colors. Now resize it so it fits on the page and you can rotate it if you want a different look to it. Now I'm going to grab a picture from the event so everybody that sees it will recognize it if they were at the event. Or they may recognize it from all the advertising that they've been seeing. Now resize it, and of course you can make it a lot fancier if you want to, but for now you get the idea. Next, I'll add our company logo just for some extra branding recognition. Once that is done, I can then download the file into my downloads folder of my computer. Now all I have to do is go grab it and place it in the front of my video. On default, it will have a little animation to it. Therefore, at the top, if you click on the crop logo, you will see the selection of Ken Burns is selected. With the Ken Burns, you can select where a picture photo starts and where you want it to zoom to at the end. You can make the end portion smaller so that it'll zoom in on a portion of what you have, just like so. Now that my title's in there, I can start adding some features to the video that I want. First thing is the transitions. If you click on the transitions tabs, you'll see a bunch of different options. When scrolling over the top of them, it'll show you the different types of effects that you will get. I will select this one and put it right in between these two clips. Now, when you play it back, you'll see it gives you a bit more of a transition versus just the regular cutting from one to another. Just another one of those little professional touches that makes it look like you put a bit of time into it. I'll go through and put a transition between everyone just so that they have a different look. Or if you want, you can use the same transition. For the next one, we're going to put in a title just so you can have a visual of whatever message you are wanting to send. You can click on the title section at the top of the screen and then you will see there are numerous positions and animations you can have to your titles. In this video, I'm talking about those posts that you commonly see in the airports. I learned that day that they are called stanchions. So in this video, I'm going to put the word stanchions just to give it a bit of that comic relief. I can drag it and put it in whatever portion of the video I want or have it looking whatever way I want. From there, I can edit the text or even the color of it. Now when I play it back, you will see that text pop up right where I told it to in that clip. Are you new to creating videos or have you created a few before? Make sure to comment below and let me know. In this shot, I have a picture of my family getting our picture taken with the chalkboard. Because I love my family, I'm going to put in a little heart just to portray that. For this, I will go to Google to find a picture of a heart. Whenever you are downloading a picture or a logo to go on your video, you want to make sure you download it as transparent. That way, everything that is around that picture will be out and you'll still see the video and you won't get a square box of a white or a black background. So I will do a bit of searching here and find a heart that I like that has a transparent background. You can tell if it's transparent when you click on the image and you see a bunch of checkerboard behind the image. If you see a checkerboard before you even click on it as a preview, there's a good chance it may not be transparent and the person that put it in there is just trying to trick you. So make sure you always click on it to see if you get that checkerboard. Once downloaded, I will drag it into the portion of iMovie where I want it. Then I will click on the crop portion of the preview and put it how I want it to appear. On this one, I will make it fade so that you can still see the video in the background without cutting it out. On this next clip, I have a picture that was taken of us. Again, I will click on the crop option and use the Ken Burns effect just to give a bit more emotion to the video with it zooming in on our faces. Again, as going, I will continue to add in more transitions. Maybe you want to add in some sound effects or even music to your video. For this one, I'm going to add a sound effect just to bring a bit more action to my video. Right now, you can't hear my screen recording, but this at least gives you an idea of how it is done. At the top, click on audio, and then you can select music from your iTunes. You can use sound effects or even music that you have in your GarageBand. I am just selecting sound effects, and then I'm taking it and dragging it down below into the portion of the video that I want it to appear in. Again, you can put whatever you want in here. Now, this one's a little long for this clip, so I'm just going to drag it and shorten it up so that it syncs with the clip. I have two clips together here and seeing they're taking some unneeded footage and extra time. First, I'm going to adjust the slider bar just under the play button so that it makes all my clips appear bigger and easier to edit. Then I will select where I want to cut out and pause the video. From there, I right-click on the video and click Split Clip. Now, it takes that video that I had and splits it and makes it into two separate clips. After that, take the unwanted portion of your video, select it, and just hit delete. Now, I have another still image showing our lunch. Again, just to add some effect, I'm going to use the title menu again and select the one that I want. From there again, you can of course select your text and color. As you can see, I can also select whether I want it left, right, or center justified. Adjust your text and you're good to go. For my final clip, I want to add a few finishing touches. First, I'm going to download our company logo and have it on the last portion of the video. Once I have it downloaded, I can then again put it into iMovie and put it in the exact position I want in that film. From there, I will drag it out so that it goes the entire way of those last three clips. Once there, select the clip image and then select and change from cutaway to picture in picture. Next, click on the crop button and under style, change it to fit. You can now take the logo and position it wherever you want. Then you can change the timing for how long you want it to dissolve in and out of the film. I am bumping this up to 1 to give it a bit more time and make it more noticeable. After looking, I don't think 1 is long enough, so let's put it to 3. Now, let's add an end screen to give it a final sign-off. I'm going to add in one last transition and then go back to the titles to pick the one I want and add it in. Change the title. Now, the color. And just like that, we are done. From there, I'll click on the logo on the top right-hand corner to export it. From here, you can upload it directly to a platform if you'd like, but I always prefer to download it as a file first, and that way I always have a copy and can always repurpose it and use it on other social media platforms. make a title and a description for it, and then download it as a 1080p resolution video like I mentioned before. I'm going to save it to my downloads, and you will see the wheel pop up in the top right corner. Since this is a decent length video, it may take some time. Once the wheel is completely white, you have your video all downloaded and ready to go. There you have it. When you get playing around with it and use it a little bit, you can really find out how easy it is to create appealing videos. Of course, this was a quick sample that I did, and with some more time and thought put into it, you can create a video that you're really proud of. As mentioned in other videos, it would be a good idea to do landscape style videos. Because I took these from my Instagram stories, they ended up as portrait, which is not ideal, but doable, depending on what platform you are using. This was just a general idea, but you get the idea. You could have so many different videos you could do here, such as neighborhood, community profiles, or even your market updates. Now that you know how to edit amazing real estate videos, you'll want to know some ideas so that you can up your social media game and attract more clients. I created a free guide for you that you can download in the description below that helped me to 10 times my social media leads. If you like this video, please let me know by liking it below, subscribing to my channel, and sharing with anyone else you may find this beneficial for. Also, comment below with any other questions that you may have about editing real estate videos in iMovie. Thanks again for watching, and I can't wait to see what you guys edit. To have a person edit their video for them? Now, on default, it will have the animation. You can make the end area focus. You can make it end up on a specific portion of your video or template.